How's it going, guys? Today's video has to do with one of my favorite topics when it comes to computers, security. And in the past, I've mentioned an important tool you can use called a VPN or a virtual private network to encrypt your internet connection and secure it from prying eyes. So today I'm gonna go over a bunch of specific reasons for when you could use a VPN that I didn't really talk about before, and we can look at some examples in action. For this video, I'll be using a great VPN service called NordVPN, who is also the sponsor of this video. So big thanks to NordVPN for that. And I do really like this service because I found it to be more user-friendly than others, and it has some pretty unique features I've never seen in other VPNs, such as special anti-DDoS servers, double VPN servers, and peer-to-peer servers for things like torrenting. So I'll put a link in the description where you can check that out. And just for you guys, there will also be a coupon code you can use as well. So to start off, the first major benefit to a VPN is the privacy you'll have when using one. When you're connected through a VPN, websites cannot see your real IP address, only the IP of the VPN server. And because there are many people using this server, you're effectively anonymous. So let me show you what this looks like. In this example, we can pick any of the server locations from NordVPN, and whatever one we choose is the IP every website will see us as. And if you want to switch IPs, you can just pick a new server, and you can instantly have a new IP address, even from another country, it doesn't matter. And you can see this page keeps showing a different IP address every time, so it definitely works. And the way it works is any connections you want to make are first encrypted and then sent to NordVPN servers, and then your connection is made at the other end of this tunnel, you can think of it as. So going back to the privacy aspect, this will also mean that search engines and other websites won't be able to track your behavior, and if you're on a school or work network, they can't spy on you and see what you're doing. And another important thing I should mention is you definitely want to make sure the VPN service you're using does not keep logs, or else, who knows, the government could show up and get your data that way. And NordVPN does not keep logs, so that is great. So, on to number two, this is another very common situation where you should definitely use a VPN, which is when connecting to an open public Wi-Fi hotspot. If you weren't aware, open Wi-Fi hotspots, meaning ones that don't have a password to connect, do not encrypt the data being sent between your device and that hotspot. So unless websites you're visiting are using HTTPS, you are literally broadcasting everything you're doing for anyone to listen in on. Like I said before, when you connect through a VPN, everything is encrypted before it even leaves the computer, so it doesn't matter if you're on an open Wi-Fi hotspot because the connection is secure. Now, I'm not even necessarily talking about your computer here though, because you might use an open Wi-Fi hotspot on your phone as well. And yes, it is possible to use a VPN on your phone. So NordVPN does indeed have an app that you can use on your iOS or Android phone along with the Windows and macOS programs. And you'll see it's pretty similar process. You just pick a server, connect to it, and your data is secure whether you're on Wi-Fi or cellular. And you'll know it's working because on iOS it will show a VPN icon at the top, and on Android you'll see a small key icon, both meaning that it's connected to a VPN. So I'm sure that there are some of you out there whom it's worth it just to use on your phone, even if you don't carry around a laptop everywhere. All right, the third reason is something I'm sure many of us can relate to, which is a VPN will allow you to bypass web filters that may be in place at your work, school, or university. Now, I'm not encouraging you to use this to waste time when you should be doing work, but there definitely are times when you have a legitimate reason to look something up on the internet and the website is blocked for some reason. And I'll show you a real life example right now where I went into my router settings and put a block on youtube.com. So if I try to go to it, there's no connection, as you'd expect. And you've probably seen places that will show you a screen letting you know it was blocked as well. There's different types of ways you can do this. Now, if we just connect to another NordVPN server, doesn't take long, you'll instantly have access to YouTube again. The block is gone. And this doesn't have to just be for a school or work filter. A VPN can also help you bypass things like countrywide internet censorship, such as the infamous Great Firewall of China. In that case, you might need a VPN to access certain websites at all, no matter where you are. so this can come in real handy. Speaking of filters though, a neat thing about NordVPN is a feature called CyberSec, which will help filter out malicious sites you might accidentally come across. And it is optional, of course, but I think it's worth it to keep it on to play it safe. All right, so now we have a fourth reason you should get a VPN, which is it can allow you to bypass location-based media restrictions in most cases. So for example, how many times have you gone to watch a YouTube video and it says not available in your country? And the same goes for Netflix, which has certain movies and shows that are only available in certain countries. Now, I don't think Netflix and YouTube would be very happy if I were to show you me actually bypassing the restrictions in this video, but it is pretty easy. As you can imagine, you just need to choose a VPN server in a country where the website will allow you to view that content. And you can see here in the NordVPN program, you can either click on a country and it will automatically select a server for you from the map, or you can go to a list of countries and pick an individual server. And you can see there are a ton of these. There's literally over 1,000 to choose from. When you're connected to that country's server, you'll have an IP address from that country and it will look like that's where you are. Very convenient. Okay, now a fifth reason you'd want to get a VPN is because of throttling from your internet service provider. Not all of them do this, but there are plenty of ISPs that will limit your connection speed based on what program or service you're using at the time. A common example is peer-to-peer downloading, such as torrenting, and I'd be willing to bet if you did a search for your ISP name and then throttling, there's a good chance a lot will come up. With a VPN, all your data is encrypted through the same encrypted tunnel, so your ISP will never know for sure what you're doing at any time, so they can't throttle anything. Keep in mind though, not all VPN services will allow peer-to-peer services like torrent, but as you guessed it, NordVPN is one of those that do allow it, which is another reason I was happy with them sponsoring this video. And they actually have some specialty services to connect to for peer-to-peer, so I'm assuming they have some optimizations with those for that purpose. While we're in this tab, I can show you some other cool specialty servers too they have. For example, there are anti-DDoS servers, which are resistant to denial of service attacks, and are good if you really want an uninterrupted connection. Then there's the double VPN servers, which I find pretty interesting. It actually encrypts your connection twice through multiple server nodes, so I don't think you can get much more secure than that. But there is another pretty unique server called the Onion over VPN, which can access the so-called Onion Router Network, or Tor, without having to even download the Tor browser. If you're not familiar with Tor, that's a bit beyond the scope of this video, but it is a very secure way of connecting to the internet, but usually requires a good amount of time to set up correctly, and this makes it really easy. So obviously there are a ton of uses for a VPN that you might not have thought of before, and these were just five big ones that I came up with. And again, I want to thank NordVPN for sponsoring this video. I definitely recommend you check it out in the description below. Like I said, it's easy to use even if you've never used a VPN before, but there are features for advanced users as well. For example, if you want to connect using the OpenVPN protocol or others, you can do that. You can pay with Bitcoin, and there's an automatic kill switch option, which is cool, which will kill the connection if the VPN connection drops, so you won't accidentally expose your real IP. So, I hope you guys found this video helpful. Be sure to let me know what you think down in the comments. If you want to keep watching, I'll put some other videos right here. You can just click on those. And also, if you want to subscribe, I make new videos every Tuesday, Thursday, Saturday. I'm looking forward to hearing from you guys, so thanks so much for watching. I'll see you next time. Have a good one.